Hello everyone, my name is Pemu Sherpa and I am Assistant Professor of English Department at McLagan College. Today I am presenting this video lecture on mythological elements in Desire Under the Elms, written by an American writer, Eugene O'Neill, published in 1924. Before starting with the mythological elements present in the poem, I would like to discuss what is a myth. So myth, etymologically, it comes from the Greek word mythos, which signifies any story or plot, whether true or invented. So myths could either be a real event that had occurred in history, or it could be just an invented or a narrated story. And myth is a story from mythology, and mythology itself is the study of myth. So mythology would be a long hereditary story of deities. So mostly mythology, it consists of gods and goddesses, stories of people possessing supernatural powers, and you having they are like super beings. Like for example, in India we have myths and epics about Ramayana and Mahabharata. So those kind of story that has been created, which consists of the stories of gods and people having supernatural powers, is called mythology. And here, when we talk that we find, when we say that we find mythological elements in Desire Under the Elms, we are relating it to classical mythologies like Sophocles' Oedipus Rex, Seneca's Phaedra, and Euripides' Hippolytus, and Myth of Medea. So these are the classical mythologies with which we find similarity with Desire Under the Elms. So moving forward, so first I'm going to discuss the myth of Oedipus and how it finds its place in, or how it is similar to Desire Under the Elms. So in the story of Oedipus Rex, written by Sophocles, so we find the character Oedipus. He kills his father Laius and marries his mother Jocasta. And here in this play, we find the theme of incest, that is murder of blood relation. And in Desire Under the Elms, just like in Oedipus Rex, in Desire Under the Elms, Eben is very hostile towards his father and wants to take revenge. And he takes revenge by sexually indulging with his stepmother Abby Putnam. So you can see the similarity, how a father is killed and the son gets sexually indulged with the mother. So in both the cases we find that similar. And in another myth, that is Myth of Hippolytus, we have the story of Hippolytus, Phaedra, and Theseus. So Theseus and Phaedra, they are husband and wife. And what happens here is that Phaedra, she falls in love with Hippolytus, and Hippolytus, what he does is that he rejects her love and she seeks revenge. So she accuses him of raping her, and Theseus curses his son, and Hippolytus die. So again, the theme of murder and incest and also revenge is there in this myth. And you can see the images of Phaedra, Theseus, and Hippolytus. Next we have Euripides' Hippolytus. So it's the same story, but here the main character is Hippolytus, and he again rejects the love of the goddess Aphrodite, deity, because he honors, or he actually admires Artemis. So these are all stories of gods and goddesses of Greek mythology, and similarly we find its similarity with our play Desire Under the Elms. So Aphrodite, see, also again see how the idea of revenge itself is being repeated again and again, and again there is the kind of adultery or getting involved in extramarital affair, where Aphrodite again, in order to take revenge, falls into love with Phaedra and makes Phaedra to love Hippolytus, and now again this leads to the death of Hippolytus. So all this is again repeating. So these are the main themes that we find again also in Desire Under the Elms, like Phaedra Abbey, that is our main character, the stepmother of Eben. She falls in love with Eben, and unlike Hippolytus, Eben accepts. So the only difference we find here is that Eben accepts Abby's love and Hippolytus does not. And again, the theme of incest is justifiable in both the cases and very much apt, and both has a very tragic fate, where in one side Hippolytus he dies, and even Eben faces tragedy at the end of the story. And again, the last mythology, that is Medea, written by Euripides, is actually a very infamous infamous crime kind of story, where a mother kills her own child in order to take revenge to her husband. So the husband, that is Jason, gets involved into extramarital affair, and his wife Medea, she kills her own child in order to take revenge to Jason. So here it is similar in the because also in our play Desire Under the Elms, Abby also murders her own child or her own son in order to prove her love for Eben, in order to say that she not only was just flirting or getting sexual pleasure from Eben, but she actually loved Eben. In order to prove this thing, she kills her own child or her own son. So again, the theme of incest. So I hope you all understand this mythological elements, and how Desire Under the Elms can be seen or can be read from this perspective. Thank you very much.